Welcome, CTO Demon channel friends. You have come to CTO Demon's cath lab in the Prince of Wales Hospital in Hong Kong. So today we are testing a model, a beating heart model of a CTO in the RCA to really learn about 3D fluoroscopic wiring. Now, what we're going to do is, those of you who have seen some of my videos know that I developed this fluoroscopic 3D wiring method called ADAPT, Angiographic Three-Dimension Antegrade Puncture Technique, ADAPT wiring. And it's mainly used for puncturing from the distal CTO body into the distal true lumen. It's for distal cap puncture. And those of you who follow the channel will know and have seen the video on ADAPT wiring. See link in description below. Now, there's also 3D wiring, which Okumura-sensei has described, for wiring a CTO body. Now, in this method, there are three ways to wire across the CTO body. There is loose tissue tracking, which is what all of you do with the XTA. There is intentional intimal tracking. This is using a wire to intentionally track the intima to go across. And there's, of course, intentional subintimal tracking, which is knuckle wiring or using something like UB3 to track a subintimal. Now, intentional intimal tracking can only be done if we have a lot of information about where the path is. So nowadays, we mainly do it for ISR CTO, where you can see the outside of the curve of the vessel, or in very calcified vessel where you can see the outside. Of course, in the far future, if CT technology becomes very good and you can integrate the CT into your angiogram perfectly, you can do intentional intimal tracking for that. Now, to do intentional intimal tracking, you need, number one, clear visualization of where the intimal path is. Number two, clear visualization of where the distal cap is. And number three, you need a high penetration force directable wire with good backup support so you can wire it. So let's play the angio for people to see. And this is the RCA CTO model we have, an RCA in segment two of the right coronary. We have set up here a Corsair microcatheter with a Conquest 12 gram wire, Confianza 12 gram wire with a 1 millimeter 45 degree tip curve. And what we're going to do is we're going to wire this. Now, we will start off by pushing this wire into the CTO body like so. Okay? Now, just like ADAPT wiring, we're going to use a cine to document both views. Okay? And in both views, our target is an imaginary line at the center of the CTO, between the proximal and distal cap. That's our target, okay? So we can see now that the wire is very much on the edge of the vessel, okay? And we can give a quick antegrade injection to show you where it is. So here, so it's both near quite the distal cap. Both are quite near the distal edge of the vessel, okay? So it doesn't matter which view is far view or near view, but for the practical purpose, since the RAO view, our wire tip is pointing towards the target, we're going to call that the far view, okay? So the center, the target is right at the center. So in the far view, the RAO, we want to turn the wire tip towards the target, which is towards the center of the vessel, okay? And then we want to check again on both views to see if the far view is still the far view, and it is. After that, the next step is in the near view, we want to rotate the wire very slightly to straighten the wire tip. Now, this serves two purposes, because as we rotate, we'll know which direction the wire tip goes towards the target and which is away. Okay? And now we know that the tip is straightened. But it also has another benefit. Straightens the wire means that the next rotation is going to be very precise. Now we're going to calculate, according to the ADAPT formula, how much we're going to need to rotate the wire. Okay? Because if it's the same distance, and this is calculated by the ratio of the shaft to target in the near view divided by the ratio of the shaft to target in the far view. So in this case, the near view and the far view is exactly the same. We are on the edge of the vessel. So it's going to be a ratio of 1/1, which means we turn 44 degrees. If it's 1/2, we turn 22 degrees. So now, on the near view, we're going to straighten the wire. Okay, and we know that if we turn clockwise, we face outwards. If we turn counterclockwise, we face inward. You can see here. So we need to counterclock 44 degrees. Okay. But in adapt wiring, instead of turning and then poking forward, we want to make a hyperbolic curve. So we want to turn as we push forward. But we want to push forward a lot if we're turning very small angles. And we don't want to push forward a lot if we're turning big angles. This is very reasonable. If your wire is pointing in the wrong direction and you push a lot, it perforates the vessel. If your wire is near to target and you push a lot, it doesn't perforate. So lesser angle of turn, more forward push. Greater angle of turn, less forward push. Now I want to go to the far view, which is this view, to locate, to observe the wire going forward. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to push and turn the wire at the same time, 44 degrees, which is 7.5 minutes. So we'll do that now. 7.5 minutes. Okay, so the wire has gone forward, but it's buckled, I think. Yes, it's buckled. Okay, so that's no good. So we have to come back. But we're somewhere. I don't know where. We will now take another biplane angle for the retrograde and see where we're at. Okay. So now we can see in the LAO view, our shaft is pretty much near the center of the lumen. In the REO view, our shaft is a little bit on the back. So the far side will be the REO view. Oh, can we have a 45 REO and 45 LAO? I forgot to say, we need accurate angles for this to work because we're doing 3D wiring and 30 degrees is not enough. So I should do this again because we're in the wrong angles. We want 45 REO, 45 LAO. Okay, eye down a little bit if possible. And we'll do another shot. Ready? Go. Okay, so actually this is clearer because we're now in 45. So the RAO, we are very near the front of the vessel. In the LAO, we are near the medial side of the vessel. Play, play, keep playing. Don't stop. So again, the both sides is quite far. Now, so we're going to take the LAO as the far view, and we're going to rotate the wire. I'm going to get more support because one of the things that we need is a microcatheter support. I'm going to rotate the wire in LAO towards the target. Oop, that flipped out a lot. Now, so sometimes this happens. The wire flips out a lot, especially since we've knuckled. So now we're in a new position. So we need another shot to determine the place. So now the RAO is the near view, the LAO is the far view, right? So on the LAO, we want to rotate the wire towards the target, like so. Okay. And in the RAO, we want to straighten the gap. Can we see the push up the bed a little bit so we can see the RAO a bit better? Okay. Can we mag up the RAO? And cone in a bit. So sometimes you need to mag up and cone in to see the tip. Okay, so this is it's difficult to see, right? But I think counterclockwise is rotating it away from the target. So here, the LAO is quite central. The RAO is also quite... The RAO is more further away, okay? So the far view is correct. The RAO is now the far view. So we should turn the RAO towards target, like so. And in the LAO, we should try to straighten the tip. Now the tip doesn't, the tip moves quite a lot. Okay, so this is the problem. Okay, we don't want to, we want to straighten. The clockwise straightens it a little bit. But the LAO is almost strap bang in the middle. So we just want to straighten the tip. And then in the far view, we want to go forward to puncture. Like so. Okay, so we punctured, and this seems like an overshoot puncture, right? We can check again. So this is RAO is now the far view. LAO is far. It's about a 44. It's about the same distance away. So in RAO, we want to turn the wire towards the tip, towards the turn the wire tip towards the target, like so. Maybe we need more LAO and less RAO.
More LAO, less RAO.
55 LAO and less RAO. A little bit less RAO, 35. Is that better? That's better. Because the RAO is difficult to see. I can't see the wire tip in RAO very well. At all. Let's see. No, it hasn't moved. Here, has it moved? Yes, it's turning towards. Okay, and now the LAO is not straight, so I want to straighten the... The LAO is towards the target, but I want to straighten the LAO. That's straightening the LAO. So, but we want 44 degrees. So we're going to turn 44 degrees counterclockwise and puncture forward. Okay, but it looks like it's slipping outwards here, right? So we'll do another injection. That's very close. But the RAO is very far, right? For the RAO, we need to turn it towards the target. Well, RAO, 好难睇啊. Cannot see the RAO at all. Okay, that's more or less towards the target. And the LAO now we want to straighten. Okay, that's enough. Straighten. I want to turn towards the target for 44 degrees. Or just less than 44, the LAO is less. Okay, that's enough. And the RAO is facing the wrong way now. So I've turned too much. So the mistake is, if you turn too much, the RAO is going to be facing the wrong way. RAO is now the right way. This looks good. So in RAO, we should push forward. Wow, what an idea. Hallelujah. And this is towards the cap. Okay, so now, another retrograde injection. So meeting some resistance here. So both are quite central. The LAO is facing the wrong direction. So we need to face the LAO to the right direction first of all. Save the last run. The RAO is, so LAO is central, pretty central. RAO is very blurred. It's also very central. We're both quite central. So now LAO is centered and RAO is centered. Let's do a cine. They're both quite centered. So we should go forward. Now either view doesn't matter now because, but we want more support before we go. Gone out. This is it. Okay. So this should be the puncture. We can see that we are now in the true lumen. We can wire down like so. Okay. So the adapt wiring basically is using the same principles to wire through the CTO body. If you turn very little degrees, you can push far forward. If you're turning a lot of degrees, you stop. Now this works in straight segment CTOs, but it doesn't work when there's a big bend. When you have a big bend, that's where the trouble is. Because each wire can only make that degree of turn. So if you think of the wire turning, if you have a 45 degree angle at the end of the wire, the arc that the wire can take is like a quadrant of a circle. And how big that circle is determined by how stiff the wire is and what is the penetration force of the wire and the plug that's around it. So you need to know your wires. You need to know how big a curve does the wire make. So Conquest 12 makes a big round. It turns around big bends because it's stiff. Whereas a Gladius EX will turn around in smaller bends, and an XTA will be able to turn around a smaller bend. If your circle is the same size as the bend on the vessel, you can make that bend with the wire, and you can stay to the center of the intimal plug. If the circle is bigger than the vessel, then you have to do what a race car driver does, which is to take the outer curve, cut through the inner curve, and go back to the outer curve to fit that turn into the bend of the vessel. But ultimately, if you have a bend that's very sharp, that wire will not do, you have to step down. So those were your principles of using wiring through a bend. Now, the last part of puncturing the distal cap, I'm gonna record another video for you again to do adapt wiring. But this is really the first model demonstration of adapt wiring through a CTO body. And I hope you like what I recorded. Do press the like button if you like it, and do subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about CTO wiring. Bye-bye.